If someone had told me that one day we'd get to see this guy in a raid again and actually heal him, I would not have believed them, but here we are. Kael'thas Sunstrider is supposedly the one dropping Ashes of Alarm. I mean, I wouldn't know since he hasn't shown me the courtesy yet, is the new boss available in Wing 2 of Castle Nathria, and in this video I'll be helping you not wipe your raid group on it. It's important to note that this is a super simple guide for LFR and normal difficulty, so if you're a more advanced player looking for heroic adventures, you want to look for additional resources. My name is Ivona, and if you're here for the first time, press that sub button because I do a bunch of super simple WoW guides for raids, dungeons, mounts, pets, and a bunch of other stuff. So if you like saving some time in WoW while getting cool loot, this is the place to be. The main goal of this two-stage boss is to heal Kael'thas to full HP and basically stop Denathrius from owning his soul forever, which is just a terrible way to spend your eternity. In stage 1, you'll find Kael'thas at 10% HP, and your goal is to get him to a lot more than that. He doesn't have any particular abilities and will mostly just be hanging around. You can't heal him with the ground healing effects unless they're placed directly on his platform, but do note that whatever you place on the platform cannot be reached by other players. Since this is a heal boss, if you're in your pre-made group, you want to have more healers than usual for this one, but if you're doing LFR, the usual 5 will just have to do. If you're a class that can heal but doesn't normally do so, throw a spell here and there to help heal the boss if the adds are under control, but there's a way you can help heal the boss that doesn't require abandoning your purpose. There are 4 soul pedestals near Kael'thas' platform that you can click on, and that way you can offer a portion of your health to the poor guy. There will be a debuff applied to you called Drained Soul, and it'll stop you from using the pedestal for 2 minutes after you've used it. Don't go for more than 2 stacks of it though, since you'll be doing more harm than good. Also, if you see someone else using the pedestal, don't try to use it yourself because you'll interrupt his cast and he will not be happy. When it comes to adds, they will keep flooding the area, and there are 6 different types of them, but you won't see them all at the same time. It's important to kind of have them stacked, so the DPS who can cleave can do their work, as there's a lot of them. Also, they'll be coming from different sides of the room, which is why having 2 tanks is awesome. Here's a tip if you're a healer, get yourself into the middle of the room, as the adds will be more inclined to stop you, and that'll make it easier for the tanks to position them. I won't go into detail when it comes to what each type of add can do, but you can find more info on that in the description. What does matter is the fact that soul infusers drop infusers orbs upon their death that can be collected, and they'll give you a super buff to your healing. It's normally best if only one healer collects the orbs and top the boss's health, but you know, do whatever you can do to make it happen. You want to ideally finish phase 1 in about 2 minutes, otherwise there will be more difficult add waves to deal with. I mean, you can do it if you take your time as well, but it'll be more difficult. In phase 2, you actually get to fight the boss, or at least a portion of him called Shade of Kael'thas, spawning at 45% and 90% of Kael'thas' health. While the Shade is around, the boss will be immune to healing from players, but whenever the Shade takes damage, Kael'thas is healed, so it's all good. After you defeat the Shade and the boss is healed, the fight is either over or phase 1 begins again, if the boss isn't at 100% at that point, but he's luckily healable after the add dies. The Shade does have its own abilities that can mess you up. The first one is Fiery Strike, which deals damage and applies the Burning Remnants debuff to anyone within 12 yards who's in the tank's cone, so it's important for it to be phased away from the raid. Another ability is Blazing Surge, which is cast when the Shade acquires 100 energy, and it deals quite a bit of fire damage to players within 40 yards in the tank cone, so facing the add away from the raid applies here too. Also, don't stand in the fire, as the Smoldering Remnants will be placed on the floor and that will hurt. There's another cool ability reminding you that Kael'thas hasn't dropped ashes for you yet, and it's called Reborn Phoenix, which will spawn 2 adds who focus on random players and move towards them to hit them. They also have some AoE damage and leave fire on the floor, so do your best to avoid that. And finally, there is the Ember Blast, which targets a random non-tank player with a debuff, and the damage taken will kill him after 5 seconds, and he'll get some fire damage stacks too. Good news is, this is split between the players within 6 yards from the targeted player, so there's a chance you can survive if your group members want to help you, so be nice to them in stage 1 and do not interrupt their pedestal channels. There will also be some fire pools spawned on the floor that will not despawn, so if you're targeted with Ember Blast, try to go to an unpopulated area to make the fight easier for the others. And that is pretty much it for this boss. In a way, it feels like breath of fresh air in comparison to the other ones in Castle Nathria. Let me know what you think in the comments, and if you haven't subbed to my channel, now is a good time because more raid guides are coming soon. If you enjoyed this one, leave it a like so more people can find it. Thank you so much for watching and have fun in Castle Nathria. Good luck and bye bye.